Mad Radio, WMDX, 92.7 FM at 1580 AM. The John and Gordy Show. And this is a very special edition of the Gordy Show.
Wait, what?
And I'm not a part of it anymore. That's the special part of it.
What are you talking about? What do you mean?
You know, no one needs me here anymore. I get the message that you could do well without me.
My technological
wizardry, you don't need my advice anymore. You know, I might as well just fade off to the side.
What are you talking
about? I keep telling you guys, you need technology in order to stay up to date in this new world that we have, this adventure in the 21st century. And you keep rejecting it all. And I feel like, I'm just kind of flying the wall now. You know, John is way over here, and it's the Gordy Show.
What advice have we rejected? What are you talking
all
about?
All of it.
What? Well, good morning to you, too. I don't know what your problem is.
No, it's
seems
not
like
my
you
problem.
Got a little attitude.
It's your show now, so.
Why is it my show?
It's all in your lap this morning.
I think it's all in your mind.
I don't know what you're talking about. Okay. Let's draw the line in the sand right now. This is it. Okay. We are getting ready for the 4th of July weekend.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
We have a special show in the can for Friday. Special Dumpster Fire Friday.
Right.
And tomorrow, of course.
4th of July.
It's going to be a best of show, I would assume, right?
Yes.
Sam?
But it's all really, really the best of. It's new best of stuff. And it's not old, dusty best of. It's really good.
And we use the term best of in a very loose way. And this is what we have to do. This is a very special last 4th of July edition of the family show.
Because?
Because we no longer have the same country anymore. Ah. It is a kingdom. It is no longer a president or an independent nation. It is a kingdom, and it's almost ironic that we have the 4th of July so close to the decision.
Yeah.
That in Chevron and put in place the unitary executive, the most powerful president in the entire world,
who has total immunity.
Total immunity for everything. So that changed the entire country. The whole country is different now.
Mm.
And the 4th of July is celebrating some kind of, some point in history.
Yeah.
You know, like.
So what are we going to do next 4th of July? It's just another day, right?
Another day. It'll be a fake holiday for those megas out there who want to celebrate what the Supreme Court did with immunity. So we have a king now, and we're back to that. We are back to that. We're not going to use the word king.
No.
But maybe we will. King Trump.
But for the time being, it's King Biden. So he's really king right now.
Yeah.
Because the immunity thing went into place immediately. So
I'm hoping somewhere along the way that the people in the administration right now are spitballing this.
They're workshopping it. They're running it around the table.
That's right. And they are going to come up with something that will kind of negate everything when King Trump takes the throne. Right?
Well, we're getting way out ahead of our skis on this. I mean, it's still 4 months till the election. There's still a lot of things that could happen between now and then.
Mm-hmm.
But you're right. The immunity thing is in place now.
Yeah.
So
it's done.
You know, maybe King Biden will do a few things to unravel some of what's been done by the Supreme Court.
It's crazy.
Could they do that? I don't know.
I don't know.
It's all a gray area. But I do know we need to get to the weather. So right now it's 66 degrees. That's the current temperature. But we need to know what the high temperature will be today, because I hear it's going to get hot and humid again.
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Well, we have two ways, really. We have the weather lottery balls.
That's true.
And we have the weather roulette wheel. We haven't really used the roulette wheel lately.
We haven't
We've been
used it
relying on the balls. But let's go with the weather roulette
wheel
today.
Okay, let's try it. Yeah, let's try the little marble.
Spin it. Here we go. We're live from Short Stack Eatery, by the way. Let's look at the number here for the high temperature. It's going to be 84 degrees today. Wow.
Yeah, red 80. That's not bad.
And more humid.
Yeah.
A little bit later on, we'll talk with Brittany Merlot and get the outlook for the holiday weekend. It's today's the 3rd, tomorrow's the 4th. All kinds of events going on all around.
Oh, yeah.
Not only Madison, but all around the area. And we'll get to those as we go on.
Big celebration for the very last time. That's fantastic.
Monona's having a community festival. DeForest will have a 4th of July. Of course, all the surrounding communities. Stoughton Fair is going on. The Catfish River Music Festival also going on at Stoughton. And the Wanna Boom. I mean, the list goes on and
it
on.
It does.
You can find all kinds of things. Do you have any 4th of July plans for tomorrow? Are you going to have a big barbecue picnic at the Peterson Estate?
The Peterson Estate.
Yeah.
No.
No, okay. That's a simple answer.
Yep. Well, you know, I had to...
What?
My younger son, he loves going out for fast food, right?
Does he?
Yeah. So last night he's really playing me because he knows I'm the easy one to convince in the family.
Yeah.
You know, let's go Culver's. Let's get some Culver's.
Culver's.
You know, he said, look, we've got 4 damn days to get Culver's. Don't do this to me tonight.
So
we just had leftovers last night. But
leftovers.
You know, now we got Culver's coming up.
Mm-hmm.
Celebrate.
Okay, well, that'll be good.
Yeah.
That'll be good. I don't really have any plans. It's pretty much an open book.
Your new place. You don't have any big party or anything.
Well, I don't have.
You're known for your.
I don't have a grill yet, and that's it's a key.
Oh, yeah.
Almost bought one the other day, and I thought, I don't know if it's exactly what I want, and I don't want to spend a ton of money on it. I like the old fashioned charcoal grill. Okay. Call me crazy.
Oh, no,
call me
that.
Crazy.
No.
I know you're into pellet grill. Yeah, I mean, that thing costs thousands of dollars that you bought. I don't need that. I don't need it. Well, how often?
Sometimes you go on sale at Menards and you get a really good deal there.
How often am I actually going to grill?
That's true.
You know?
That's
just
true.
For myself.
Yeah,
I mean,
I know.
I live a lonely life.
It's not a good idea. It really isn't to get an expensive grill.
Right. I don't need that.
No, you don't need that.
Why would I get
that? I agree.
Okay.
I agree.
Yeah. But I almost bought one that was on sale, you know, but I don't know. It was kind of between medium and small size. But it would be just right
perfect.
For me.
Right.
Yeah, I just passed
even,
on
even
it,
when, though. You know, the family comes over, right?
Yeah.
They come over all the time, don't they?
No, they haven't been there yet, really.
That's kind of a sad story.
It is, I know.
But
it's a long story. We don't have time to go into it.
Yeah.
Oh, well, my son lives in Indiana. He can't just, you know.
Well, that's true.
He's like 6 hours away, so.
Yeah.
So he doesn't come up, but my daughter's up in Baraboo. She's pretty busy. She works full time. So it's pretty tough
to do. Tough to get off. Yeah.
Yeah. So there you have it.
Been there, done that in radio. We never have time off. We never have any way to spend time with the family.
No, I don't know.
I don't know my family.
You don't know your family?
Really? Yeah.
Do you have their phone numbers?
This will all come out on the Pete Schwabba show.
Are we going to be on that someday?
Well, someday we're going to be on it. I hope next week sometime.
Okay.
Yeah. But, okay, I know, four
right.
minutes.
Let's,
got it.
Let's get
four
into...
Four
okay.
minutes.
All right. Let's get into the National Day calendar, shall we?
All right, let's do that.
All right.
I was going to say on Pete Schwabba when Pete has my cousin on.
Oh, yeah, Jeff Cesario. Yeah,
we'll go at it. Everybody will know then that we are not a close family.
Okay, here we go with the National Day
All
calendar
right.
for today, July 3rd. Is it French Toast Day?
Or not.
Is
it not?
Is it Fried Clam Day? Is it Plastic Bag Free Day? Is it Chocolate Wafer Day? Or is it Eat Your Beans Day? Which day is it not, John Peterson?
Fried clams? What the hell are you talking about?
Is it a day or not? Are you on some kind of hallucinogen? I wish. Should I go over the list again?
No, fried clams is my guess.
That's your answer?
We can only handle...
You think it's not?
...handle your review of these days once.
Is it or is it not National Fried Clam Day?
It's not Fried Clam Day.
Well,
who would do with
you're
that?
You're wrong. What? It is Fried Clam Day. Sam, do you have a guess or were you paying attention?
I was.
Just sleeping on the job.
It's not okay. French Toast Day.
You are correct, sir.
All
it
right.
is not French Toast
Unbelievable.
Day.
Unbelievable.
But it is.
I guess you can throw anything into a fryer, right?
Apparently, you can.
In Wisconsin, we do that all the time.
Okay.
Oh,
Let's
God.
See. Is it International Plastic Free Day? It is, as it turns out.
Yes.
Okay, I'm running a different computer than my own here.
Yes,
how do you do this? Okay.
You use the
is
mouse,
this a
Gordy.
Touchscreen?
No, it's
is
not.
It? Oh, yeah, the mouse. The mouse. Mouse. The mouse is in the house.
Technology.
Okay. International Plastic Free Day is July 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
Plastic Bag Free Day. And we're encouraging people to try to cut down on the use of plastic bags. Today, let's all make a little extra effort to help save the environment, okay? Most people only use a plastic bag one time, then they throw it away. Single-use plastic bags have motivated some cities to ban them altogether. Some cities that have banned those include Leaf Rapids, Manitoba, San Francisco, Los Angeles, Portland, Seattle, and Mexico City. You can still get plastic bags in Madison.
Yeah.
I know that.
Yeah, you can.
Five facts about plastic bags. It takes between 100 and 500 years for plastic bags to disintegrate. Wow. We make 5 trillion plastic bags each year. The average person uses plastic bags for about 25 minutes. Every minute around the world, we use 1 million plastic bags.
That is insane.
Isn't it, though? And plastic bags kill around 100,000 marine animals each year. Wow.
Jeez.
Besides being bad for the environment, plastic bags are also poorly designed, or they rarely get recycled. Even though, you know, we think they're recyclable or somewhat, but... They don't really end up being that, apparently.
Yeah, they should be in the recycle bin.
Yeah, they should be. So, you know, here's 7 ways to have a plastic bag-free day. Do we have time for
no,
this?
No, we're
done. We don't
done.
Have time for this.
Yeah,
okay.
We have less than a minute here.
All right, we've got a whole lot more of show to go. And a little bit later on, we're going to be talking about... what are we going to be talking about? We've got Johnny at the Movies. I know
we
that's
do.
Coming up.
We do have that.
And we have a guest as well. Don't have that information apparently right in front of me, but we will get to that as we continue live from Short Stack Eatery at the corner of Johnson and State, the John and Gordy Show.
Radio, WMDX, 92.7 FM, 1580 AM, broadcasting from the fantastic, great city, capital city of Wisconsin, Madison.
That's right.
And State Street, the hub of the Midwest.
It is. And there's a lot of activity going on right now, getting ready for the 4th of July weekend. You know, everybody's getting set. They're making their 4th of July plans. People are traveling today. It's one of the biggest travel days of the year as we get into a long weekend. What are you doing with your new coffee cup over there? You having trouble with it?
Is there like a double way to put this thing on or something?
Well, I don't know.
There is. There is a double way.
It's really, I think it's quite a cool cup.
It's a cool cup, and if you're left or right-handed, it depends on where you start screwing the cover on.
Is that right?
I didn't know that.
So it's ambidextrous.
It is.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. It's kind of a thermos.
Now, let me show
but it's
everybody
short,
what this
it's
is.
A short thing,
See,
but
it
holds a lot of coffee.
It won't tip over.
All right.
It's fantastic. I just got a free cup of coffee.
Do they know that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Short Stack Eatery.
I told them I'd be over.
Put it on our tab.
Yeah. That's right.
It's National Fried Clam Day, getting back to the national days on the calendar.
Why would we do that?
Why? Well, it's to honor an iconic food in the New England states.
Throw it in the fryer. That's the way we honor food. Throw it in the fryer.
They like it. They like these clams up in New England.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Let's explore a little bit of history of fried clams, shall we?
Aren't they baked normally?
Well, seaside clam shacks or roadside restaurants up in New England serve these delectable nuggets, and they tend to be the primary source for anyone seeking them. Huh? The clams are dipped in milk. I don't know if that sentence
made any
sense. Talk
about a word salad.
Clams are dipped in milk and then coated with a combination of regular corn and or pastry flour. Mm-hmm. Then the coated clams are fried in oil. They can be clam strips, sliced parts of hard shell clams, or whole soft shell clams. Whole soft shell clams impart a fuller flavor. However, some restaurants remove the clam's neck. I think I've had clams a couple of times when I lived in Boston.
Not thrilling.
Wasn't,
who cares?
Wasn't really wasn't really into it.
Hardly anything there by the time you get them breading, and it's all breading.
Well, that's it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's move on.
Pastry flour, though, is an interesting little nugget from what you said.
Okay.
I did not know that.
All right. Well, it's also National Chocolate Wafer Day. Chocolate wafers.
Ah, yes.
the chocolate wafer. Yes, Chocolate Wafer Day has come around again. It allows us to indulge in a delicately sweet cookie with a history. Do we care about the history of the chocolate wafer?
Probably not.
Okay, let's just move on.
Okay, let's move on from there.
Why would we have a day devoted to chocolate wafer? It's the national day calendar, so every week has to have something about chocolate in it. And this is today, and we don't care. National Eat Your Beans Day. Eat your beans. Okay.
Yeah.
It's a live, healthy holiday that falls on July 3rd to celebrate the bean vegetable in all sizes, shapes, and colors. Beans date back to the early 7th millennium. Wow. And making them one of the longest cultivated plants. There are approximately, get this, 40,000 bean varieties in the world. Mm-hmm. So you don't get this information anywhere else except John and Gordy show.
No, you really don't.
And you don't really need it.
You know, they have these thin French beans. Those are really good.
They have a list of a whole bunch of beans. Many of them I probably couldn't pronounce. So let's just move on.
All right, yeah.
Because the history book is coming up here shortly. We want to get to it. The National Compliment Your Mirror Day. That was...
Compliment your mirror?
Compliment your mirror.
It's kind of a backward way of saying, hey, I'm looking good today.
I'm looking good. Most of us look in the mirror every day, according to the National Day Calendar people. July 3rd is a great moment to take a moment to compliment yourself before rushing through your morning rituals.
Oh, my God.
Our mirrors go through a lot of work, it says here.
That's very sad life.
It's hard work for mirrors. They see us at our worst and at our best.
Yeah.
It's time to, they're given their due. This is a bunch of crap. I'm not even,
it's
I'm not
It's almost
it.
Like, you know, the talking mirror and Snow White, right?
Well, right.
Who needs it? Who's the most... beautiful of them.
Yeah, I know. Sam, let's get to the history book. Why
don't
you open it up?
Is it time?
It's four fingers up.
Oh, boy.
Is it time? It is time. Let's open up that history book.
See what happens.
Wow.
Quite the book we got.
Okay, what page are we on? Okay.
We're on today's
page.
What is it?
Today's page for July 3rd.
July 3rd. Today in 1806, the modern strawberry is introduced to the farming world. It was known as the Keen seedling. It was a hybrid of two naturally growing species.
Oh, you mean like the poison ones that are in people's front yards?
They do have poison.
We went over this, John.
Right?
We went over this. They just don't want you to eat their strawberries.
That's true. Well, she said that you can't eat them. They're bitter. They're not the kind you eat.
Mm-hmm.
They're not eat, John.
That's right. So,
there you go.
Yeah. I stayed clear of that yard.
Well,
she
got what she wanted. Today in 1886, Carl Benz, he gives his first public demonstration of what would become the automobile.
Wow.
Mercedes-Benz.
Yeah.
Yes.
1886.
It didn't look... Have you ever seen his original car?
No.
It didn't look like... It, it was three-wheeled. The wheels were like bicycle wheels. And it was basically just a bench on top of this thing, and you steered with a handle like on a bicycle. There wasn't a steering wheel or anything like that. It was real goofy looking. Come a long way.
The birth of a luxury vehicle.
Right. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see. Today in 1928, do you know the name John Logie Baird?
No.
He was a pioneer in the early days of television. He invented mechanical television. Mechanical television. So think of that with whatever you want. But today, in 1928, he demonstrated color mechanical television.
Hmm. Okay.
Big stuff. Way ahead of his
time. That's kind of weird. I remember when they were experimenting with color for black and white TVs. And what they did was they had some kind of staticky thing going on, some kind of particulate in the screen, not on the screen, but in the video. And it gave the appearance of color. And I remember the experiment, and I watched it, and it did work a little bit. Turning black and white TVs into color.
I don't remember that, but I remember the first time I saw a color TV. It was at our neighbor's house.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was 9 or 10 years old, something like that. Mm-hmm. And they were watching Bonanza, and that was in color.
Boy, that was in...
It was real color.
It was vivid color.
Like crazy color.
It was. It was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So... All right, Sam, anything else on the big book of history?
Sam? Yes, we do got a couple other
Sam
things.
Sam dozed off there for a second.
No.
Well, you slept in this morning, didn't
you?
I did
sleep in. I slept in by half an hour, so I was a little
Your alarm clock
was a little behind this morning.
What?
No, well, my alarm went off at 4:30, and then I closed my eyes, and when I opened them again, it was 5 o'clock.
Just like magic.
Wouldn't happen if you had an Alexa waking you.
Oh, I'm
All
sure.
All right, let's continue with
I'm
the...
I'm sure
the,
we
go again. All right.
The history book here says that there is a famous death.
Yeah. Yes. We're almost out of time here. But today in 1971, Jim Morrison passed away.
Yeah.
Okay.
Was that in a hot tub or bathtub or something?
I think he drowned
in a bathtub in Paris. They never did an autopsy, though, so there's a bunch of theories about what happened.
Mm-hmm. Back to the Future premiered on the stage in 85.
That's it. All right. Coming back with more of the John and Gordy.
Civic Media Now proudly present... Proudly? Proudly. Seriously, that's a stretch. How about, here they are, John and Gordy. Let's go with that, shall we? Proudly. Give me a break. Who writes this crap?
We did. Yeah, we did.
We snuck it in there. Yes, the John and Gordy Show. This is the last 4th of July edition of the family show.
You're predicting that there will be no more 4th of Julys after
this
one.
Well, there shouldn't have to be because we're not that kind of country anymore.
Ah, okay. Yep.
It'll be a kingdom.
We're not going to celebrate freedom and liberty and all that?
Well, no, I guess it's a holiday. You could, you know, like Thanksgiving, right?
Right.
You know, that's past, long past. It just, you know, is as a tradition.
Okay.
And we'll do that with the 4th of July, but it won't mean the same thing.
Gotcha.
You know, we're not going to celebrate our freedoms or independence.
So.
Now we're just a kingdom.
We're going to shoot off the fireworks still? Because, you know, the fireworks people, you know, they make a lot of money on 4th of July.
Only if you can aim them at somebody.
Okay. All right. It's the John and Gordy Show live from Shortstack Eatery.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I want to mention something weather-wise today. 66 right now, highs in the upper 80s, mid-80s, 84 for a high, and it's going to be humid. And the John and Gordy Show is sponsored by Verlo Mattress of Madison. Sleep better, dream bigger on a handcrafted, locally made mattress. You can find them on Madison's east and west sides. Or just go online at verlo.com. That's verlo.com. Happy to have them along as a sponsor of the John and Gordy Show. Again, live from Shortstack Eatery this morning. Okay?
All right.
Okay.
Sounds fantastic.
It is fantastic.
Fantastique.
Yeah.
They're saying in France.
Is that what they say?
Do they say that? Do they say it like that there?
I don't know. Did you see this thing? This is the most pointless website on the planet. We were looking at this, you know, a couple of minutes ago.
Yeah.
This thing. What's it called? 1 million checkboxes. Is this? Have you seen this?
Yes.
Are you looking at it?
I am.
It has a vibe like Wordle. I was never really into Wordle. Is Wordle still a thing? People don't put it on Facebook anymore.
I don't think so. I don't think anybody cares about that stuff.
Not anymore. Well, this is a website with a million little boxes in a row, and you click on a box to make a check mark, and now that box is checked for everyone who plays the game. You don't quite get that. An odometer-like counter keeps track of how many boxes all the game players have cumulatively checked. People love chaos and they're unchecking boxes as fast as others check them to watch the counter go backwards. So it's kind of a competition. Sam, what do you know about this? Anything?
It's almost
well,
like...
Well, I was going to jump in with something real quick. Catherine's on the phone, and she's the one who sent it in. Let's see what she has to say about it.
All right.
Maybe
hey, Catherine, she has a little more information on
about
this.
About this million-dollar, what is it? 1 million checkboxes.
We're baffled by this.
Yes, Kathryn, explain this to us.
What's the thing for you guys? I got on the web to check my email, and this stupid story comes up in the Washington Post. And of course I check on it. And I'll be darned if it is not the stupidest thing you've ever seen. It is literally a website with checkboxes on it. And you go on and you start checking boxes at the top of the page, because, of course, you can't see that there are literally a million checkboxes. You have to scroll down. Mm-hmm. It's like a big, wide-open field. And so if you stay at the top, and I click a couple boxes, and then somebody in the world clicks them back, and it sort of made me angry, so I scrolled down, started clicking some more, and somebody else was there, and I'm clicking my damn boxes. So I scroll to the bottom, and there's somebody down there just randomly checking a couple boxes. So I ignored them, and I went off to my old little field, and I clicked in high. Clicked an H-I. Nobody responded. But as I clicked in my initials, it's the stupidest thing ever, but it just reminds me of all the video games that our kids are playing. It's about as smart as our other our kids' games, I think, John, that your kids are developing. This is as good as that.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I think this doesn't sound as good as anything.
Well, it sounds like you're having fun with it, right? It says, it's for hours of pointless joy. So it's just mindless. It
sounds like our show.
Yes.
It's a little like that. I think I'm a little over the top because I haven't slept. My daughter is here, and she decided she needed to sleep with me last night, so I haven't slept. But I'm on my way down to see you guys, so watch out.
All right.
Well, great. Well, have fun playing 1 million checkboxes. I'll have to check it out. Okay.
All right. Okay.
Thank you, Kathryn. All right.
An odometer like Connery keeps track of how many boxes all game players have cumulatively checked. People love chaos. That's ridiculous.
Well, that's not discounted.
I mean, it's like a competition,
fun.
Right? Trying to keep ahead.
I was going to say before, there was a thing on Reddit a number of years ago where, like, literally hundreds of thousands of people got together and they created this giant, like, collaborative pixel art sort of thing. It was on the subreddit r/place. I don't know, Gordy, are you familiar with this?
No.
It was like all these different groups and communities, like where you could only click one dot at a time and you could only make it one color, but everyone was able to make like this collage of all these different pictures and art. And it's like this huge thing. Once you lay it all out, it was really cool. This just reminds me of that.
Sounds nice.
Well, it says as far as 1 million checkboxes go, about half a million people have played it so far, and they've checked or unchecked boxes roughly 200 million times. They didn't expect it to be very popular, but apparently this is all the rage right now. 1 million checkboxes. It's just a mindless game.
No one thought it would be popular.
Okay.
So they put it on the internet, and now it's taking off.
It's taking over. Yikes. All right. Okay,
we do have a topic.
You want something to...
Well, you know what? This is the last 4th of July edition.
Well, you keep coming back to this.
Of the family show, because, you know, we're celebrating something now that's in the past, like Thanksgiving and all this other stuff, all these made-up historical markers.
And this now, is going to be just one of
this
them.
Will be a nut. This won't be made up, of course, but it'll be something to reminisce on. You know, when we declared our independence, when we separated from the King of England,
right?
And now we've got our own king.
Yeah,
we've put that person in place.
Yeah, we have a monarchy.
And one of the shocking parts of this is that this is all devised by and created by a former president.
Right.
He put all these Supreme Court justices in, hook or by crook, and mostly by crook. You know, they refused to put a president in that Obama wanted to put in because there wasn't enough time before the next election. They wanted the voters to make that decision.
To make a new Supreme Court
BS that was anyway.
Yeah, that was completely crap.
And then, you know, a few weeks before the next election, they installed their own and said, well, that doesn't apply. You know, the old rules don't apply anymore.
Right.
It was such a con. That alone should have at least told a lot of the MAGAs and Republicans that this is not a legitimate party anymore. It's just a game.
Right.
But anyway, so I found this kind of an interesting part of history. On March 1933, the Enabling Act becomes law in Germany, giving the chief executive the power to enforce his own laws without checks and balances. Sound familiar?
That does sound familiar.
The passing of the act marked the formal transition from democratic republic to totalitarian dictatorship. 6 months later, it was a one-party state. And once they got total power, they didn't give it up until millions were dead at their hands. And parts of Germany were flattened. It doesn't bode well historically.
No, it doesn't. It's a little scary. In fact, it's a lot scary.
Yes.
Yeah, if you read the history books of those times in Germany, it's just, it's unbelievable.
It
just kept growing and getting worse, and then World War II happened, and boy, oh boy. It's frightening, really.
Yeah, Justice Barrett has put it to words. She shows why the court and maybe the special counsel, and you know, remember, Barrett is the conservative.
Yes.
She's this is the one thing she disagreed on. Mm-hmm. The sole question should be whether acts relating to running for president are core. She says, take the president's alleged attempt to organize alternative slates of electors.
Yes.
In my view, that conduct is private and therefore not entitled to protection. And while Congress has a limited role in that process, the president has none. None.
Right.
In short, a president has no legal authority and thus no official capacity to influence how the states appoint their electors. She says, I see no plausible argument for barring prosecution of that alleged conduct.
So she's stepped out of the conservative justice's corner.
Just on that section.
She
agreed
part.
With the general decision, but in this she objected to their reading of it.
Well, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
I mean, she's right on that.
Somebody on X said this, they have created King Benedict Donald.
Great. That's got a nice ring
to it,
doesn't it?
Yeah, it does have a ring to it, doesn't it?
Oh, boy. What are we in for here?
And this comment I thought was kind of, it hit it right on the head. The SCOTUS decision was antithetical to the Declaration of Independence and U.S. Constitution, showing that the Roberts Court could easily deem the worst court in U.S. history.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And,
Yeah, so happy 4th of July tomorrow. You know, they...
the last one.
Todd Alba mentioned something on his show yesterday. They actually signed it on July 3rd, the Declaration of Independence. But because of printing and marketing and everything else, you know, got to get the word out and everything.
Wow.
They didn't really get the word out until July 4th.
Yeah.
So that's why we celebrate on the 4th. But what will we have to celebrate after this 4th of July? Well, I don't know.
Well, I guess the crowning of our king.
The crowning of the king.
And right now it's Biden first. King.
Yeah. Well, you know, there's a lot of events going on around Madison and the area.
Yeah.
Like the Monona Community Festival that starts today, goes through tomorrow, Winnequa Park in Monona. They're going to have music and a carnival, art fair and food, fireworks. Of course, there's going to be all kinds of fireworks. You know, bring the dogs inside, try to calm them down. I bet your dog is going to go nuts with the fireworks.
You know what? We don't know.
This is his first 4th of July with you.
Yes.
His or hers?
Her.
DeForest is having a 4th of July celebration that begins today at the Fireman's Park in DeForest. It goes through tomorrow. Music, kids' activities, beer tent, fireworks at dusk. I don't know. I think it's important to mention some of these. Kids want to do something.
No, I think it's great.
Yeah. Stoughton Fair, that's happening beginning today. It goes through the 7th of July, which is Sunday. Matt Park in Stoughton, they're going to have a carnival and exhibits. Mm-hmm. So there are all kinds of things going on that you can do Catfish River Music Festival is going on at the Stoughton Opera House tomorrow through the 6th at Rotary Park in Stoughton. And the Wannaboom in Wanakee, that begins tomorrow at 2 o'clock and goes till 10:30. Music, kids, activities, fireworks, all kinds of fun stuff.
The Wannaboom.
Wannaboom. Wannaboom.
The Wanakee.
Yeah. What happened to the Madison Boom? What was it called? The Boom... Shakalaka Festival or whatever.
Bims and Booms. I can't remember.
Bombs
and Booms.
Maybe. It was a big deal.
How soon they forget,
well,
right?
It was a huge event.
Just, and all of a sudden, we can't even remember the name of it.
When it got so big, they decided not to do it anymore. It was just too, it was too big to handle. Yeah. So.
And then there were too many rainy sessions to deal with.
What was that?
Boy,
I can't remember the name of it now. It went on for 15 or 20 years.
It was a big event for all media.
Remember they used to have the simulcast music playing with the,
They did. You listen to the radio. Yeah, the music going and then the fireworks going at the same time.
Yeah.
It was a real event.
It was a big event. A little bit later on, we're going to be talking with Terry Parisa. Excuse you.
Sorry about that.
Terry Parisi will be here from the Parisi Family Farm talking about sustainable agriculture. Yeah. This is a big, big thing.
It is.
And
buying local. That's what it's all about.
Well, yes. And more farms and farmers are getting on board with sustainable farming. And
that's right.
We'll find more out about that coming up in our next hour as we continue with the John and Gordy Show live from Short Stack Eatery, downtown Madison, Johnson State.
Mad Radio, WMDX, 92.7 FM at 1580 AM. Getting the feeling that perhaps my headphones might be a little on the louder side.
Yes.
I'm comfortable with them.
You're comfortable with them.
But the feedback is not a good thing for you guys.
No. So try to keep your headphones away from the microphone when you take them off.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Got it.
Okay.
Hey, take it easy.
We got it. We got several texts
reminding
us what the name of that big 4th of July thing was, Rhythm and Booms. How could we forget?
That's right. The rhythm part is playing the radio at the same time the fireworks were taking place.
It was a great festival. Wonderful. Wonderful,
It was great. It was just too...
It just got too big.
Too big, and you never knew when it would rain and have storms and ruin the entire event.
Well,
Remember the boot that fell out of the sky when I was watching fireworks?
What? No.
When I was a kid.
What?
When I was a kid, the fireworks went off and a burning boot fell out of the sky. Landed right in front of us.
What a horrible experience that must have been for you. A burning boot.
Yes.
That came from.
Well, that's a good question. It didn't have a foot in it. It was just a burning foot.
Well, that's
good. So, and that was, I haven't forgotten it to this day.
Apparently
it
not.
It was my traumatic experience experiencing fireworks,
that
and that's why I'm not a big fan of fireworks.
Because
I don't know what they're packing in those missiles.
Boots, maybe?
Boots and junk
just
and leftover
random,
clothing.
Random crap.
Yeah. Go to the Goodwill and let's get some more missiles put together here.
God,
it's just awful.
Hey, is it time yet for Johnny at the Movies?
It is time for Johnny
at
the Movies.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, we normally have it a little bit earlier, but we got our show just got too filled up yesterday, so we're going to play it today.
Jam-packed.
So let's get into it.
All right.
And now, here's that master of the cinematic arts, Mr.
John Peterson.
The passion, the pathos, the honesty, the despair.
Hello again.
Never before have the torments of movie critics been so vividly portrayed.
One ticket or two, sir.
Well, just number nine five, or so. The Indian film Kalkai 2898-80, bringing in $5.5 million. And number four was Bad Boys Ride or Die, with $10.3 million. And number three was the newcomer, directed, written, and starring Kevin Costner. Horizon and American Saga Chapter 1 brought in $11 million. And the other new release this past weekend, A Quiet Place Day 1, brought in $53 million. But nothing was big enough to overcome Inside Out 2. In its third week of release, it gained $57.4 million. Now, worldwide, it's grossed over $1 billion, making it the first film since Barbie to cross the billion mark, and it's reached $1 billion in the fastest amount of time for any animated movie in history. This week, it will face off at the box office with the new movie Despicable Me 4 arriving in time for the July 4th holiday.
All right.
Okay, that
so that's
wraps
pretty
it up.
Good, right?
Yeah.
Now, well, let's find out what's coming this weekend to the movie theaters.
Okay. Well, we have three new movies, and it's going to be a spectacular weekend at the box office. The first is Despicable Me 4. Gru faces a new nemesis, while little Gru Jr. is now around to torment his dad. You can expect the adorable minions to be there every step along the way. In this one, we had the voice talents of Steve Carell, Kristen Wiig, Will Ferrell, Sofia Vergara, Stephen Colbert, and more. We're going to have a great run at the movies with Despicable Me 4. The second movie is The Sound of Hope, The Story of Possum Trot. This is from Angel Studios, who really stunned audiences last July 4th holiday with the release of their movie, The Sound of Freedom. The Sound of Hope, The Story of Possum Trot is the true story of Donna and Reverend Martin and their church in East Texas, where 22 families adopted 77 children from the local foster system, igniting a movement for vulnerable children everywhere. This is a wonderful and uplifting story from Angel Studios and is getting spectacular reviews. And the last movie is Maxine. This is the new release from the studio A24. This is part of a series that includes the original film X, its prequel Pearl, and now its sequel Maxine. Starring Mia Goth, she plays an adult film star and aspiring actress from the 1980s that finally gets her break, but at the same time, a mysterious killer is stalking the starlets of Hollywood. This is also getting great reviews on Rotten Tomatoes. There is so much to see this holiday week, including Inside Out 2, Despicable Me 4, and all of the movies we just mentioned. Go check out a movie today.
All right, so it sounds like a lot of good movies out there to get out back into the theaters, especially on this weekend. You have like a lot of days to do it.
Sure. That Inside Out 2 just keeps going on, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Did you see the first one?
I did.
Yeah?
I did. It was so long ago, I have forgotten about the movie completely.
Really?
And I don't remember much about it.
I mean, the way he was talking, it sounded like it's going to be bigger than Barbie, or maybe already bigger than
Barbie. Well, I hope not.
What? You're wearing your Barbie t-shirt today.
I didn't even notice that. Yeah.
That's nice. Looks good on you.
Well, thank you. The pink, right?
Yeah.
Pink goes with the pink nose that I have. I don't know what I'm talking about.
What?
Yeah,
what
you know how it is.
Okay.
All right. Hey, I want to play a little track here from the BET award show.
Okay.
And I'm not even sure who is giving this speech in the award show, but you mentioned Project 2025, of all things, at this award show. It is Cut 20, and let's check it out. Let's hear what she has to say.
Time for us to play chess, not checkers. It's about making decisions that will affect us as human beings, our careers, our next generations to come. Did you know that it is now a crime to be homeless? Pay attention. It's not a secret. Look it up. They are attacking our most vulnerable citizens. The Project 2025 plan is not a game. Look it up.
Wow.
We featured the Project 2025 plan here on the show.
Yeah, a few weeks ago.
Yeah. Every aspect that we could find at the time. Right. A lot of people are filling in the blanks at this point as well. I'm glad it's picked up a lot of steam. You know, for everybody to pick up on that project, that plan from the Heritage Foundation and the right wing is just tremendous, and I hope this catches on a little bit. But I have to say I am completely disappointed in the Democrats, as I always am. And I have an honest, good feeling that maybe Biden will stay in there and continue to be the candidate for president. despite what the Democrats do when they shoot themselves in the foot over and over and over again.
I saw a new Biden commercial this morning that I think really is good.
Oh, yeah?
Really
yeah.
good. And, of course, he's going to be in Madison this Friday.
That's right.
Day
yes.
after tomorrow.
Yep, in the afternoon sometime. They haven't yep. given an exact location as yet, but they will be.
Yeah.
And we'll give you a notification
yeah.
about
yeah,
that
we'll
if we can.
We'll have coverage here on Civic Media for sure. Hey, coming up in our next hour, right around the corner, we'll be talking with Terry Parisi from the Parisi Family Farm. It's all about sustainable agriculture when the John and Gordy Show continues.